Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act 2021. I am Dr. Suresh Padidmat, Professor of Psychiatry, working at NIMHANS, Bangalore. Before I start my presentation, I would like to place this disclaimer. This presentation is for academic and training purpose only. For legal opinion, please do contact an advocate. This video is not a substitute for legal opinion. Conflict of interest? None. In this video, I am going to discuss about the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act 2021 and also Medical Termination of Pregnancy Rules 2021. This video is targeted to registered medical practitioner, that is basically doctors, gynecologists, nurses, healthcare professionals, and general public at large. Let's discuss and define Medical Termination of Pregnancy. Medical termination of pregnancy is a procedure that uses medication or surgical procedure to end any pregnancy. It can be only medical method or a surgical method, or combination of both medical and surgical method are used in medical termination of pregnancy. There are various issues surrounding the medical termination of pregnancy or abortion, such as religious belief. There are many religions which completely prohibit abortion. The main reason being is, as soon as the conception occurs, that is, egg and ovum meets, it is considered as a life. Hence, killing that will be considered as against the religion. Further, what are the moral values, ethical values in that society? Along with that, medical ethics, how can a healthcare professional who is supposed to protect life is taking life? Social and cultural values of the society. Rights of the mother versus the rights of the unborn child. Rights of the mother versus the rights of the father. Unmarried women being pregnant is a big issue in many countries. To regulate all these things, there are legal procedures, laws have been enacted by various countries to regulate medical termination of pregnancy. Let's discuss about the Indian legislation with regard to abortion law. The law on abortion in India is primarily governed by Section 312 to Section 316 of Indian Penal Code, and also the provision of MTP Act of 1971, which is recently amended in 2021. If you look at the Indian Penal Code, that is abortion law, which we have inherited from the Britishers, Section 312 IPC clearly says, whoever voluntarily causes a woman with child to miscarriage, which clearly says 3 years of imprisonment. Only the exception is to save the life of the mother. If you are done, then it will not be punishable. Otherwise, 3 years imprisonment. Section 313 IPC clearly says, whoever causes a woman with child to miscarry against the consent of the mother, in such a scenario, life imprisonment or 10 years imprisonment is considered. If you look at the Section 314 IPC, during the miscarriage, if the death of the mother occurs, so which was an intent to cause a miscarriage with or without consent of the mother, 10 years imprisonment or life imprisonment will be given. If you look at this Section 315 IPC, act done with intent to prevent child being born alive or to cause it to die after birth, again, 10 years imprisonment or life imprisonment will be given with or without fine. Coming to the Section 316 IPC, causing death of a quick unborn child by act amounting to culpable homicide, 10 years imprisonment with or without fine. So these are the Indian Penal Code which clearly sanctions punishment for abortion, even medical termination of pregnancy. But however, there are some exceptions which Indian Penal Code has brought in. That is, to save the life of the mother. Under that, medical termination of pregnancy was implemented in 1971 and recently amended in 2021. So let's discuss about the medical termination of pregnancy in 1971, which has an exception to the law criminalizing the abortion laid down from 312 to 316 of Indian Penal Code. So medical termination of pregnancy, amended Act 2021. This is the legislation which was passed on 25th March 2021. The Act amends the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act of 1971. This 1971 Act played a crucial role for 50 years. And this was a very progressive law in a secular India. Further, this Act came into force on 24th September 2021. And rules were notified on 12th of October 2021. So this is the legislation which I am going to discuss in detail in this video. Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act 2021 has 8 sections. Section 1 talks about short title, extent and commencement, definition. Section 3 talks about when pregnancy can be terminated. 4 is places where MTP can be done. Section 3 and 4, when not to apply. Section 6 talks about power to make rules. 7, power to make regulation. And Section 8, protection of action taken in good faith. So these are the important 8 sections which have been brought under Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act of 2021. But however, we need to know why there was an amendment. The amendment occurred to see and also be progressive as the society has changed. This law clearly brings in the change in the mindset of the law and also the drafter. In the old legislation, everywhere it used to mention married pregnant women. But however, nowadays, it is unmarried also can become pregnant. Hence, it is considered as pregnant women. So, only married people can become pregnant was the notion earlier. But now, it is pregnant women. Earlier, it was considered as husband in 1971 Act. Now, it is considered as a partner because of living relationships are becoming common in urban area. So, let's understand under medical termination of pregnancy, the number of opinion required. One RMP, that is one registered medical practitioner for termination of pregnancy up to 20 weeks of gestation. And two RMPs are required for termination of pregnancy between 20 to 24 weeks. And a state level medical board is essential for pregnancy to be terminated beyond 24 weeks. So, in this amendment, it has increased the scope of MTP from 20 to 24 weeks and also brought in a medical board after 24 weeks of pregnancy. But however, there are two conditions for medical termination of pregnancy. First, the continuation of the pregnancy would involve a risk to the life of the pregnant woman or of a grave injury to her physical or mental health. Further, the second condition is there is a substantial risk that if the child were born, it would suffer from any serious physical or mental abnormality. So these two points, that is the safety of the mother's life, physical and mental health. Further, the serious injury, physical and mental health of the unborn child. So these are the two important conditions which have been placed. But however, let's understand the explanation given in the legislation. Any pregnancy occurs as a result of failure of any device or method used by a woman or her partner for the purpose of limiting the number of children or preventing pregnancy, the anguish caused by such pregnancy may be presumed to constitute a grave injury to mental health of the pregnant woman. Simply, the explanation one is, failure of contraception either by the woman or by her partner will be considered as a grave injury or anguish for mental health. Explanation 2. Any pregnancy is alleged by the pregnant woman to have been caused by a rape. The anguish caused by the pregnancy shall be presumed to constitute a grave injury to the mental health of the pregnant woman. That means if there is a rape, in such a scenario, it will be presumed the anguish which will impact our mental health. So these are the two important points which has been considered as an explanation. So as I mentioned, contraception of failure. So that is a very important point, especially in India. We have 140 crore population. Under this act, a pregnancy may be terminated up to 20 weeks by a married woman or by an unmarried woman also. So that is the paradigm shift in the thinking of the law drafter. Let's discussion of MTP of a gestation from 20 to 24 weeks. As I mentioned, up to 20 weeks, A single registered medical practitioner can do it. But however, the issue becomes complicated when it becomes 20 to 24 weeks. Here in this legislation of 2021, the scope has been increased from 20 to 24 weeks with under special categories. That is section 3, 2, subsection 2, SC and D. That is where it has been discussed. Under rule 3B, who are the women who are eligible for MTP up to 24 weeks? Survivor of sexual assault and rape, minors, change of marital status during the ongoing pregnancy if she becomes widow or divorce, women with physical disabilities, mentally ill women including mental retardation, the fetal malformation, women with pregnancy in humanitarian settings or disaster or emergency situation as may be declared by the government. So under this situation, a lady can ask for medical termination of pregnancy up to 24 weeks. But however, two RMPs, that is registered medical practitioners, has to accept it. And they have to opine, yes, we can go ahead. And two RMPs should be there when this pregnancy termination occurs. So for me, is the one where the two RMPs will opine. This is how the form E looks like. Now let's discuss about medical termination of pregnancy of gestation beyond 24 weeks. This legislation that is amended in 2021 talks about medical termination beyond 24 weeks. That is under section 3 and subsection 2 C and D. It has to be done under the supervision of state level medical board, which consists of gynecologist, pediatrician, radiologist or a sonologist, or such other number of members as may be notified in the official gazette or by the state government. That means the three has been mentioned, but however, the state government can increase the number of members in the state medical board. Here, this power of the medical board has been dictated under Rule 3A. The power clearly says to allow or deny the medical termination of pregnancy beyond 24 weeks. If they are allowing it, it has to be safe at the gestational age beyond 24 weeks, and there should be a substantial risk of being incompatible with life of fetus or handicapped. These are the two important conditions which has to be examined by the medical board, and the board also can co-opt the specialist. So please remember, the medical board has to give opinion either to allow or deny MTP beyond 24 weeks based on whether the MTP is safe after 24 weeks to the mother, or else it causes the substantial risk of being incompatible with life of fetus or handicapped child is going to be born. Moving to the 3A rule, that is functions of this medical board. This has been clearly defined under the rule, which says to examine the woman and her report, provide the opinion of the medical board in form D, and also to ensure MTP occurs in a safe precautions measures. Counseling has to be done before the MTP, and within 5 days of receipt of the request, MTP has to be done. That means 5 days has been clearly defined under the rule. This is how the form D, where the medical board members are going to sign and give their opinion, either the allowing for the MTP or denying for the MTP. But however, Act 2021 talks about confidentiality, which is very important in the digital era. Under Section 5A of the Act clearly says, the name and other particular of a woman whose pregnancy has been terminated shall not be revealed except to a person authorized in any law that is currently in force. If the confidentiality is broken, 1 year imprisonment with or without fine has been clearly mentioned under the legislation. Now we have known how the MTP is done. But where should be done? What are the places medical termination of pregnancy is allowed? It is allowed under the Section 4, which clearly says a hospital established or maintained by the government or to be approved by the government or a district level committee. The district level committee consists of the chief medical officer or the district health officer as the chairperson. The committee also can consist of many other members, which should not be less than 3 members and not more than 5 members, including the chairperson. That means it can have either 3 people, 4 or 5. It cannot have more than 5 people. So this is the committee which will give permission for the places where MTP can be done. And let's discuss about the requirement of those places where medical termination of pregnancy is allowed. It is allowed in such a places up to first trimester, that is up to 12 weeks. That is a place where gynecological examination and a labor table should be available. Resuscitation and sterilization equipment should be available. Drugs and parental fluid should be available. Backup facility for treatment of shock and facilities for transportation is to be available if they are going to do first trimester MTP. That means these are the places where this committee will give permission. Requirement for second trimester pregnancy where the MTP can be done. So those places where they are going to engage in second trimester MTP should have an operation table and instrument for performing abdominal and gynecological surgery. That means OT should be there. Anesthetic equipments, resuscitation equipments and sterilization equipment should be available. Drugs and parenteral fluids for emergency use, notified by the Government of India from time to time, should be made available in such places. Requirement for MTP beyond 24 weeks. That means it is a major procedure. An operation table and instrument for performing abdominal or gynecological surgery should be available. That is basically OT. Anesthetic equipments, resuscitation equipments, and sterilization equipments. Availability of drugs, parenteral fluids, blood for emergency use, as may be notified by the central government from time to time. And facilities for procedure, ultrasound guidance should be made available in these centers where they are going to do MTP beyond 24 weeks. And it should also has the medical board as mentioned under the rules. This is how the application should be placed by a doctor for approval of his center for MTP. And Form B is the one where the committee gives approval and similar certificate will be given to the hospital and they have to display this in a prominent place in their clinic. Now the question comes, who can do medical termination of pregnancy? Can anybody? No. It is registered medical practitioner can do the medical termination of pregnancy. But however, we need to know what are the situation, what are the training that is allowed under this legislation. Registered medical practitioner means a medical practitioner who possesses any recognized medical qualification as defined by Clause H of Section 2 of Indian Medical Council Act of 1956, but now it is National Medical Commissions Act. And his name should have been entered in the state medical register and who has such experience or training in gynecology and obstetrics may be prescribed by the rules under the act. That means apart from being an RMP, his name should be registered. Further, he should have undergone certain trainings and those trainings are prescribed by the rules. Let's look into the rules now. The training requirement has been defined under the Rule 4 of the MTP Rule 2021. The registered medical practitioner before 1971 and who has 3 years of experience in OBG can do A. B. RMP who has completed 6 months of house surgery in OBG, or if RMP had experience at any hospital for 1 year in OBG, or assisted 25 cases of MTP and done 5 cases of independent MTP for first trimester. And now, under the new legislation, there is CA has been added. That is 3 months in OBG or 10 cases of independent MTP if he has done, he's eligible. And D, the diploma or PG and OBG if they have passed. These are the people who have been mentioned. But however, depending upon the procedure, this ABCD criteria has been placed. Up to 9 weeks, medical termination of pregnancy is done, but that is by giving only medication. The people who are eligible are all A, B, C, CA and D criteria. Up to 12 weeks, here the surgical procedure is allowed. Here, A, B, C and D criterias need to be fulfilled. Those are the RMPs are allowed. Beyond 12 to 20 weeks, A, B and D are allowed. Beyond 24 weeks, 2 RMPs should be there. They need to give opinion and they should be there available during the termination of pregnancy. A, B and D is very essential. But however, I would rather place my reservation here. any procedure which has to be done by surgical needs to have post-graduation, either diploma or MD or MS in OBG has to be done, depending upon the place where the university gives the post-graduation diploma in OBG. Let's understand the difference in 1971 MTP Act and 2021 Act. See, if you look at the first column, they are the variables. The second column is MTP Act of 1971. And the third column is MTP Act of 2021. Look at the indications. Here, MTP Act of 1971, contraceptive failure for married women was allowed in 1971. But in 2021, unmarried women are also covered. If you look at the gestational age, in 1971, 20 weeks, till 20 weeks it was allowed. Whereas in 2021, up to 24 weeks, and further, beyond 24 weeks, under the supervision of medical board and the permission from medical board is allowed. If you look at the medical practitioner's opinion required before termination, 1 RMP till 12 weeks, but here in new legislation, 1 RMP till 20 weeks. 2 RMPs till 20 weeks in 1971, here 2 RMPs from 20 to 24 weeks, and medical board approval after 24 weeks is required. Breach of confidentiality. Fine was there only 1,000 rupees in the old legislation. In the new legislation, 1 year imprisonment with or without fine has been clearly mentioned. That means 2021 legislation is very progressive and been considering the society, how it is moving. The legislation has taken that progressive nature into account. Let's look into the various forms which have been given under the rules of MTP Rules 2021. Form A. It is the application placed by a registered medical practitioner to get the approval of a center for MTP procedure. Form B is the certificate given by the committee as an approval to conduct MTPs in that place. Form C is the consent for MTP. If it is an adult, that means the first part will be filled. If it is a minor, then the second part will be filled by the guardian. Form D. That is a report of the medical board. That is the state medical board which gives permission for MTP beyond 24 weeks. This is how it looks. There, the clearly, if you look at the item number 6, which talks about MTP allowed beyond 24 weeks, allowed or denied. And also physical fitness for termination of pregnancy of women is there or not. And the signature of all the medical board members are being clearly mentioned under Form D. Moving to the Form E, this is the opinion of the two registered medical practitioner under what circumstances, under the rule which they are permitting for termination between 20 to 24 weeks. That means two RMPs has to sign. Coming to the last part of my presentation, this MTP Act of 2021 has been amended reflecting the changes in the society, and that has increased the scope of termination from 20 to 24 weeks. And under the supervision of the medical board, up to beyond 24 weeks is allowed. Definition of pregnant woman has been changed. Earlier it was considered pregnant married woman. Now it is just a pregnant woman. Earlier it was husband. Now it is her partner. So this legislation clearly mentions the change in the mindset of the drafter and the society. So this is a very important to understand how the societal norms are changing, and destigmatizing the pregnancy outside the marriage is also been considered. But however, if you review the MTP Act, there are certain drawbacks. Clearly, it says that this MTP Act is medical centric. That means RMP's permission or opinion is required. But however, if you look at the two landmark judgments from the Supreme Court, one is Suchitra Srivastava versus Chandigarh administration, which was given in 2009. And again, it was emphasized in Justice K.S. Puttaswamy versus Union of India, given in September 2008. In both the landmark judgment, the Supreme Court has clearly upheld the rights of the woman with regard to reproduction rights. That means woman has a right whether to have a pregnancy or not have a pregnancy. Here, you are bringing a medical opinion. So this has been considered as a violation of their rights. This is being discussed by the various human rights activists. So this is one of the biggest criticism by the human rights activist. Further, RMPs not having degree in OBG are allowed to do MTP, that is medical termination. this can have a detrimental effect on the medical termination of procedure when a surgical procedure is conducted. This is the second important. This legislation is one of the landmark legislation, progressive in nature, and few criticisms are there. But however, this law clearly indicates our society is progressing and a one step ahead to clearly say that women in our society has legal reproductive rights. Thank you very much for giving your valuable time. Stay safe.